Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Islamic Beliefs. The argument from design. The teleological argument is actually a series of various arguments which can be lumped under one heading and put forward the argument that from the design and order of the universe there must have been some kind of designer. It is probably most famous within the Western tradition in the watch analogy struck forward by Pelley, although without a doubt had existed long before him, and alongside the cosmological argument was probably one of the first theistic defenses in natural theology. In spite of its evaluation and popularity in the Western tradition, the argument was put forward far earlier by Muslim theologians and philosophers alike. The argument focuses upon the order and balance which exist within the realm of creation and posits that there can be no better explanation for the order and balance in the universe than a divine order or someone who has produced this universe with order and balance in mind. In essence, the argument flows as follows. Number one, order exists in the universe showing the signs of design. That is to say, within the universe there exists beauty, there exists harmony, there exists a world of pleasure and of itself which cultivates life and therefore must be viewed as being complex. Number two, everything which shows the designs of design must have a designer. That is to say that this world cannot be empty result of chance and chaos, because chance and chaos produce chance and chaos. They do not produce order and harmony. They do not produce sequence, nor do they lead to producing anything which is intrinsically viewed as art of craftsmanship. Number three, therefore the universe has a designer, and that designer is God. That is to say that when we as feeble human beings appreciate art in the forms of paintings and poetry or say something like beautiful and creative architecture, we would never reduce such order and structure found within such disciplines to being merely the results of random chaotic forces creating them out of nothing and particularly out of chance and no intended purpose. If someone were to critique the work of the great artists such as Da Vinci or Van Gogh, or great poets and playwrights like William Shakespeare, to be merely randomly and chaotic produce abstract objects of randomness caused merely by the forces of nature within themselves originated from nothing, we would dismiss such a talk as being delusions of mentally deranged person. What then of someone who says such about this great universe that we inhabit, which itself inspired all of this a masterful human art in the form of poetry, architecture, and what have you? Some will try to add a doubt in the minds of rational man by citing the existence of evil in the universe to somehow act as if such existence necessitates disbelieving in a creator, namely God. A Muslim scholar has succinctly put in response to such claims the following point. If the world is orderly, then evil. If existence at all functions within the structure of the world's order, an animal which produces poison does not change any and every food into poison. Rather, it too behaves within the organized network of relations and produces poison and destruction within the boundaries of the existence order. The argument from design can be rendered defective only if either the present design's purposefulness is denied or is not ascribed to an orderer. However, the argument's tenability is not subject to absence or presence or evil in the world. Thank you very much for watching. Fi amanillah.